Respected Chairman Sri M. Lakshman Reddy sir, Executive Director in absentia Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav sir, other management members, Dean, HODs on stage, last but not the least, the staff member and the engineers of St. Martin Engineering College, very good evening to all of you. So today, as we are celebrating the Engineers Day, and wholeheartedly I would like to congratulate and wish all of you a happy Engineers Day, because we all are basically engineers. And already we know very well that why this Engineers Day is celebrated, because it is the birthday of our beloved engineer, great engineer, Bharat Ratna, Sir M. Visveswaraya. And already we know that he was from Karnataka and a very small village near to Mysore. And he has come from a very humble and poor family. And with great difficulty he could able to finish his education. Because at the age of 12, he had lost his father. And as you know, the main source of the income for an Indian family is the father. And if somebody lost his father, then the child has to be more responsible than anybody else. So he has to take care of the mother and the family, and also he has to take care of his studies. So parallelly, with all strength, he maintained it very well. That is why he was appreciated, and he got lot of scholarship from his school day itself. And with his scholarship, he had completed all of his educations. So that is the era of how he had struggled and how he had completed his, you know, educations and all. Those days British was ruling, British government was there. So Nasik, he got a job and he was working for the British government, and he worked for several years, and almost, you know, many countries he has travelled. So, and even the Britishers, the foreigners, those days also many civil engineers were there, and he was one of the civil engineers in the team. So whenever there is an idea or there is a proposal comes for the implementation, it goes to a debate. And Sir M. Visveswaraya sir used to give a unique idea and an innovative approach to solve the problem. Because of his humbleness and because of his knowledge, he was respected everywhere. And as you know, he lived for 102 years, so which is, you know, not a joke. And it is very surprising for me to note that at the age, very late age, nowadays at the age of 40, 45, 50, now people used to, even a doctor also used to tell to all of us that, no, you are attaining to near to the age of 60, if somebody is attaining to the 50 also. So at the age of 1 or 2 years, he was fit, fine. Even on the last day of his life also, he has lived his life like a legend. And all of his activities he used to do himself. So that is the, you know, level of positiveness, that is the level of energy, and that is the level of knowledge he was carrying. And at the age of 92, 93, he was there enough to take the responsibility of new projects. So now, the present generation, if you will see, okay, so if any new responsibility was given, so there are a lot of issues are coming up. But at the age of 92, 94, 95, he was there enough to take the responsibility. And it is not like taking the responsibility, he was owning the responsibility and ensuring that the work is done at the fullest. And his contributions are a big list. If we will start talking about it, there is no end to it. But, you know, let me remember his greatest contribution for Hyderabad. I think all of you might be knowing about one river in Hyderabad, Musi River. Okay, so the beauty of the Musi River is whenever during the rainy season, the water level goes off, and that is the reason the Hyderabad has to face flood every year. And there was no remedy for that. And those days were all, government were there for Hyderabad. They have approached to Sir M. Visveswaraya, and Sir came and did a survey. And he told that one, yes, it can be controlled, and if we will complete this project for Hyderabad, throughout the decades, there is no scope of flood because of the Musi River. And that was the reason. Now also you might be knowing the Himayat Sagar and Osman Sagar, which is all parkland and developed and finally executed by him. Till today we are getting the benefit of it. And his contribution is not only restricted in his own state. His contributions are spreaded across the country. You name out any state, his contributions are there. There is a great dam that is named as Hirakud Dam. If you somebody visits Odisha, you will see how beautiful it is constructed, named as Hirakud Dam, and the water is clotted there, and by using that water, we were able to harvest the electricity. And till today, it is the biggest dam in Odisha, and that was a great contribution by Sir M. Visveshwaraya. And he was the first man who gave the concept of how to harvest electricity from water. And he was the person who told about how to do the block irrigation. There are n number of contributions, as already before me, Dr. Hemant Mika was already telling to all of you about Krishna Raj Sagar Dam. So I will make it a little bit more technical, why this Krishna Raj Sagar Dam was famous. So the Krishna Raj Sagar Dam, it is there in Mysore, if you go. Okay, the length of this dam is 3.5 kilometer, the length of the dam, and the height, if you will see, almost it is 125 feet. That is the height, and 3.5 kilometer was the length. So those days, that was the highest and the longest dam what we were having in India. And he was the person who first thought of developing a dam of that size and successfully completed, and till today we can see the success story of his plan. And we are going for Tirupati Tirumala Darsan, right? Tirupati Tirumala Darsan, whenever we go for that road what we are seeing, that is called Ghat Road. That Ghat Road is also his contribution. He has done it. So his legacy and his signature of doing the work is a big list. And he was very humble, and the Mysore University, that is also his creation. He had first decided. And when he was doing the work dynamically, as you know, wherever the skill set is there and we started doing our work dynamically, there are lot of people also who are all watching him. And he was getting lot of offers from the foreign government also. Please come take care of this project, that project and all. And the beauty and the simplicity of Sir M. Visveshwaraya is, he used to visit, he used to see all this. And what is his thought in his mind? That facility, that infrastructural development, I have to inculcate in my own country. And all the knowledges, whatever he was gaining, he wanted to implement it in India, and the fullest he has done it. And he was the first man who encouraged and appreciated for the private investment in the government. And till today now, that is a great venture for any individual to invest money and grow along with the government. So he was not only an engineer, I will say that he was a 360 degree complete personality what he was holding. He was a great motivator, a great hard worker, and he is very sincere, responsible, and a very humble person. So it is really very proud that we are belongs to the same country where Sir M. Visveshwaraya was born. And also it is a proud moment for all of us, because he was an engineer and we are also possessing the engineering profession in our life. So always he used to tell only one thing: simplicity and hard work. This is the two things will lead to a successful life, and it will take you to very next level. In his legacy and in his leadership, already by counting all this enormous contribution for the country, government has felicitated him with the highest civilian award, that is Bharat Ratna. So he was called Sir M. Visveshwaraya Bharat Ratna Award. So that is his life, and there are legacy, and there are the contributions and all the days it is all spoken, and all the days it is all taken as an example. You could also able to see in our campus itself, we have one building name we have given in his name, Sir M. Visveshwaraya. And if you go to Karnataka, there is a technical university, VTU, Visveshwaraya Technical University. And there are colleges, engineering colleges, which are all running in his direct name, like Sir M. Visveshwaraya College of Engineering, Institute of Technology. So in different parts of the country, it is all spread. So his legacy and his contributions are in such a way that everybody wanted to acknowledge him by heart. So that was the man, that was, you know, Bharat Ratna, Sir M. Visveshwaraya. So we are, you know, very proud to be a part of this day, and the government has decided to celebrate his birthday as an engineer's day, because he was known as a great engineer for the country, and he has created a separate identity for India out of his own knowledge. So that is what the credit goes to Sir M. Visveshwaraya, and we are very proud and fortunate to remember him and to spend some time for remembering his work and the contribution for the country. Now we might be thinking, okay, so already all this work has been happened. So as an engineer, what is the opportunity for all of us to develop? See, we can, as already we are all engineers, we can also divide and we can also think in a multidimensional way and do something for the country or whatever the profession we have chosen for. For an example, I wanted to quote, recently there was an article in the newspaper also, the highest or the tallest tower in South India, it is proposed to construct in Hyderabad. So there is a place called Kokapet in Hyderabad, all of you might be, might be aware of it. So some builders have taken 4.5 acres of land and the construction work is already initiated. And what is the signature and what is the identity of the building? Tallest tower in South India. And why it is called the tallest tower? Because the height of the tower will be 228 meters and it will be having 57 levels, and there are 235 residences are going to come up. And it is 57 levels, I told. And next to that, in Bangalore, we have, as of now, the tallest tower, that is 50 levels. And now what we are constructing in Kokapet, that is 57 levels. Is not it that great something what the people and the engineers are doing? And now you imagine, as the tallest tower in Hyderabad, it is going to come. Undoubtedly, it is going to be a tourist place, as it is already, because of high-tech city and Charminar, and there are many things in Hyderabad. So that is one thing. And you imagine how many number of civil engineers are required, how many architects are required, how many electrical engineers are required, how many mechanical engineers are required, and how many all these IoT related and computer science and IT engineers are required. So now we have to look into it and we have to see how we can inculcate all this information to our own student. So in future, who knows, there might be another M. Visveshwaraya from our student community also. So we are talking about, interestingly, we are still talking about the challenges of the 5G technology. And till today, 5G technology full-fledged, it was not implemented in India. And there are a lot of pros, cons we are discussing, how it is possible, all these things. But very surprisingly, if you will, you know, read the articles and all, there is a, you know, country you already know, that South Korea. So in South Korea, they are using 6G technology for past 2 years. What we are struggling now? For 5G. And South Korea is using 6G technology. Similarly, there is a country called Norway. If that country you will see, for past 2 years, they are using 7G technology. And still we are working out for the 5G technology. And we are talking, debating whether it is good, bad, what are pros, cons and all. So this is what it is. So as an engineer, so we have to understand what is going on everywhere and we have to inculcate this kind of technological advancement and this kind of, you know, the future upcoming technologies for the student, so that undoubtedly every engineer will be benefited. And if you start thinking in these directions, definitely there will be a flag bearer for the nation. So with this note, I would like to say thanks on behalf of all of us to our respected chairman sir. And whenever I see our chairman sir, I used to recall, Sir M. Visheshwaraya, because if you will see Sir M. Visheshwaraya's photos and, Sir, more or less lot of similarities is there, like how he was lean, Sir is also lean, and that is how he was very fit, Sir is also equally like that. So that is what it is, and always it's not like that. We will able to learn only from the engineers. Even the people, those who are having the engineering mindset also, we can learn many things. Even though Sir used to tell in many of his talk, so they don't have proper education during their school days and childhood and all. But one person, he thought of building an education system, engineering colleges, and now you are seeing how many colleges they are all managing and how many engineers for the country they are all producing. A great salute to you, Sir, even though you are not engineer, but you are capable of producing thousands of engineers for the country, and they are all only across the globe, they are all spreaded, and they are contributing in their own way, whatever the profession they have chosen for. So finally, I would like to once more congratulate all of you and wish all the very best, because we all are engineer and we are directly or indirectly contributing for the nation. And have a great evening ahead. Thank you for listening to me, and thanks for the opportunity.